was to see everybody's views on that. So, people, if they have time, you can download this study, you can download it free, it's lifetime problems of psychotic and bipolar 1 disorder. The answer from that study, which is a very good high quality one, is 0.87. Actually, psychotic disorders, they are 3.04. So the number is quite high. But we're talking about now, we're able to diagnose and sub-diagnose more. So schizophrenia is 0.87 based on this one. So just for you. Go ahead.
What's the confidence interval for this number?
So that you can do when you have less than 1 minute for this one, but you can download the study. So. Okay. So there's four statements in this one. Total cholesterol and LDL levels were significantly decreased in patient versus control, or they were significantly increased. Triglyceride levels were significantly decreased in the patient, and leptin level was significantly increased. There's only one statement true out of those four. Number two, any other answers? Number four, it's not two. So any second guess? Four? What number four?
Leptin is a hormone that controls the appetite. When it is high, the appetite is low, which is not the case in this disease.
Any other options?
One.
Number one? Number one, so cholesterol, total cholesterol and LDL are decreased.
Yeah,
and increase the answer is yes, actually, it's number one. That's why it's here, because actually cholesterol levels are decreased, they are not increased, and triglyceride are significantly increased. It's again a very interesting study. It just recently published at the BGPsych. People who are members of college, they can access that free. If you can, you can email me if you want to know more about that. It was one of the things that I was reading, huh? Doesn't make sense.
They say, they talk about
first
episode psychosis.
Yes.
What's schizophrenia?
No, I'm saying, I did not say this schizophrenia, I said which one of those.
You're talking about chronic disorder, what?
First episode.
Yeah.
No, it's not the night, sorry about that, okay.
Yes, that's what I was going to
read. Yes. No, not after you take a very heavy metabolic drug that could affect you. Okay, now there's a new neurology treatment trial for schizophrenia. There's a new drug. It was in the news about 3-4 days ago that they're gonna use a drug that is either used with MS, epilepsy, Korsakoff, Parkinson, or Huntington's.
Parkinson's, thank you.
So there's a trial, a big trial, about a drug that treats one of those conditions that now we're trying it for schizophrenia. Parkinson's? No? Sorry? It's MS drugs. There's a new MS drugs. Now they're trying to go now with the schizophrenia is an autoimmune. And now they're starting a trial, a big trial, to see a new MS drug to treat schizophrenia. So there's a lot of autoimmune disease, immunology, and they say about, you know, even you go with toxoplasmos causing schizophrenia, and you try to see there's a lot of studies. Is it or is it not? We don't know. But I'm saying that's what's kind of in the pipeline. So people are investing money to see whether that's going to help schizophrenia. So there is some, but that's the first study. So, you know, is there any connection between MS and schizophrenia? No, because there's no clear connection. But for whatever reasons, I think one of the treatment might be quite working with schizophrenia. And my last one about dangerousness, do we think patient with schizophrenia, they has no increased risk of violence in comparison to general population, or they do have significant increase?
Two.
Yes, so we have the two answers. Actually, it is two. So that's from the Swedish registry. It is significantly increased. So we're talking about minimum double, and it might go up to four times if there's drug abuse.
But actually, when you read in the literature, yes, I agree with you, violence is obvious in psychotic patients. But when you read the literature, they usually say compared to the general population, they are the same. Based on it is maybe provoked by the hallucination, by substance abuse, by delusion. I agree, it's more.
It's all literature. So there's any publications that's coming in 2010 onward, they say, you know, we were thinking, yes, it was the general population, it's similar, all of that. That's wrong. All the more latest studies, I would say, bias, media, all of that, and it goes into media. No, when you're talking about, so, you know, we know all the Swedish studies, they can give you more, it's like more clear ideas. That's why they said cannabis can you know, cause schizophrenia, and we've got with this, so they did compare with the general population, that compare with previous hospital admission. So the minute you have one admission to hospital for schizophrenia, you'll increase that when it goes like, you know, from 4% to 17% at times. So previous admission, drug abuse, there's a lot of different variables, but overall, it is significantly at least double than the general population or more than that.
Can I just add something?
Yeah.
Can I just add something? Even when you're just substance misuse, alcohol, up to adjustment, the odds ratio is high.
In terms of the psychopathology, I think patients with schizophrenia have delusions of control, passivity phenomena. In terms of active psychotic symptoms, are more likely, much more likely to be violent compared to patients who've got schizophrenia with other symptoms.
Yeah, I'm talking about, so what we're trying to say is, historically, when we say schizophrenia by itself, the diagnosis doesn't, yes, there's a lot of risk factor, but having a diagnosis of schizophrenia, actually, if I make it like a bluntly, it's the same thing when you say high blood pressure can, you know, cause this or that. There's always like different patients that they might, or some of them more risk of MI or not, but in general, I mean, schizophrenia is something that make you need to look at, you know, violence and increased risk of violence to others. So those are, when I say facts, is just, you know, supported by evidence, recent studies, most of them. So we're talking about now myths. We have Dr. Mudhat, hopefully is going to tell us about some of the myths.